Sairam students, welcome back. I hope you all are fine today. Let us continue with our history. Lesson number 3, in the earliest cities. In our previous class, we had learned about the story of Harappa. That is how the engineers stumbled over the site of Harappa, which is in present-day Pakistan. And how nearly 80 years ago, the archaeologists found this site as the oldest cities of the subcontinent. And as this was the first city, so similar buildings and other things, they were described as Harappan. Then we learned about what was special about these cities. We learned that the city was divided into two or more parts. Then we learned about the citadel and the lower town. And the great bath that was discovered in Mohenjo-daro. Cities like Kalibangan and Lothal, they had fire altars. And cities like Mohenjo-daro, Harappa and Lothal, they had elaborate storehouses. Then we learnt about houses, trains and streets. That is how planned these three were during that time. And the drainage system, it clearly shows that the people, they paid great attention to hygiene and sanitation. Then we also learnt about life in the city. That is, a Harappan city was a very busy place. And the rulers, they planned the construction of the special buildings. And they sent the people to distant lands to get metal, precious stones, etc. And scribes who knew how to write, they helped in preparing the seals. And craftspersons made all kinds of things, either in their own homes or in the special workshops. And the people who were traveling to distant lands, they returned with the raw materials and perhaps the stories. And many terracotta toys have been found. So the children, they might have played with these toys. Today, let us learn more about the Harappan cities. That is, we will learn about new crafts in the city in search of raw materials and food for people in the cities. Now, let us begin with new crafts in the city. That is, most of the things that were found by the archaeologists, they were made of stone, shell and metals like copper, bronze, gold and silver. And copper and bronze, they were used to make tools, weapons, ornaments and vessels. And gold and silver, they were also used to make ornaments and vessels. Children, here you can see in the image. Children, perhaps the most striking finds are those of the beads, weights and the blades. Now, let us learn one by one about them. First, let us learn about the stone weights. Now, these were made of chert, that was a kind of stone. And they were usually used to weigh precious stones or metals. Children, if you see the weight of the Harappan cities, it was cubical in shape. And in India, if you see today, the weight that we find are the iron weights. And they are used to measure the goods on a scale in the markets. And the Standards of Weights and Measures Act, it was passed in 1976. And it adopted the metric system to regulate commercial transaction and industrial production in India. Now let us learn how the beads were made and used. Many of these were made out of carnelian, a beautiful red stone. The stone was cut, then shaped, polished, and finally a hole was bored through the center so that a string could be passed through it. and beautiful ornaments were made out of them. Here you can see in the picture. Now let's learn about seals. The Harappans also made seals out of stone. These are generally rectangular and they usually have an animal carved on them. The Harappans, they made pots with beautiful black designs. You can see here in the images given, children. Now let us learn about cotton. Children, do you remember we had learnt about Mehrgarh? Yes. So the cotton was probably grown at Mehrgarh from about 7000 years ago. And actual pieces of cloth, they were found attached to the lid of a silver vase and on some copper objects at Mohenjo-daro. So by looking at those, the archaeologists, they came to know that cotton was grown during that time. And the archaeologists, they also found spindle whorls made of terracotta and faience, and these were used to spin the thread. Children, look at this example given below. So we can have an indirect evidence to show that how cloth was decorated. For instance, a stone statue of an important man was found at Mohenjo-daro, which shows him wearing an embroidered garment. Now let's see what is faience. Unlike the stone or shell that are found naturally, faience, it is a material that is artificially produced. And a gum was used to shape sand or powdered quartz into an object. So what was used to shape the sand or powdered quartz into an object? Gum. Okay. Then the objects were glazed, resulting in a shiny glassy surface. And the colors of the glaze were usually blue or sea green. So what were the colors? Blue or sea green. And faience was used to make beads, bangles, earrings and tiny vessels. Here children, you can see in the images given how faience was used to make beads, bangles, earrings and tiny vessels. So many of the things were produced at that time. And who did this work? It was a work done by a specialist. So who is specialist? A specialist is a person who is trained to do only one kind of work. For example, cutting stone or polishing beads or carving seals. Children, look at the illustration given over here and see how well the face is carved and how carefully the beard is shown. So, this must have been the work of an expert craftsperson. But everybody could not have been a specialist, and we do not know whether only men were specialists or only women were specialists. Perhaps some women and men may have been specialists. Now children, let us learn the next topic, that is in search of raw materials. What are raw materials, children? Raw materials are substances that are either found naturally, such as wood, ores of metals, or are produced by the farmers or herders. So raw materials, they are the substances that are found naturally or produced. And then these are processed to produce finished goods. For example, cotton is produced by the farmers, and cotton, we know that it is a raw material, and that may be processed to make into a cloth.
while some of the raw materials that were used were available locally. But many items such as copper, tin, gold, silver and precious stones, they had to be brought from distant places. That means they had to get it from other places. So from where did the Harappans get copper? The Harappans probably got copper from present day Rajasthan and even from Oman, that is in West Asia. And from where did they get tin? They might have brought tin from present day Afghanistan and Iran. And tin was mixed with copper to produce bronze. So which two metals form the alloy bronze? Yes, tin and copper. From where did gold and precious stones come from? Gold could have come all the way from present day Karnataka, and precious stones could have come from present day Gujarat, Iran and Afghanistan. Now let us learn the next topic, that is food for people in the cities. So from where did the people in the cities get food from? So we know that many people, they lived in the cities while others, they were living in the countryside, and they grew crops and reared animals. So farmers and herders, they were living in the countryside and growing crops and rearing animals. So these farmers and herders, they supplied food to craftspersons, scribes and rulers in the cities. So to whom did they supply food to? They supplied food to the craftspersons, scribes and rulers who lived in the cities. Now let us see, what did the Harappans grow? The Harappans grew wheat, barley, pulses, peas, rice, sesame, linseed and mustard. How do we come to know that they used to grow all these things? We came to know from the remains of plants that the Harappans grew wheat, barley, pulses, peas, rice, sesame, linseed and mustard. So the Harappans, they used to eat these things. And children, we also eat these things even today, isn't it? Children, do you know what was used to dig the earth? Yes, a new tool, the plow, was used to dig the earth for turning the soil and planting seeds. While real plows, which were probably made of wood, have not survived, but toy models have been found. So we can say that the farmers, they used the plow to dig the earth for turning the soil and planting seeds. Children, do you know, today in many farming communities, only men, they use the plow. We do not know whether the Harappans followed such customs or not at that time. Children, as this region does not receive heavy rainfall, so some form of irrigation may have been used. This means that water was stored and supplied to the fields when the plants were growing. So how did the Harappans irrigate their fields and grow plants? Yes, through stored water. That means they used to store the water and supply it to the fields when the plants were growing. Children, which animals did the Harappans rear? The Harappans, they reared cattle, sheep, goat and
buffalo. And the water and pastures, they were available for these animals around the settlements. However, during the dry summer months, large herds of animals, they were probably taken to greater distances in search of grass and water. And they also collected fruits like bear, and they caught fish and hunted wild animals like the antelope. Now children, let us recap the topics that we have learned today. We learnt about new crafts in the city. That is, most of the things found by the archaeologists, they were made of stone, shell and metal, such as copper, bronze, gold and silver. And bronze and copper, they were used to make tools, weapons, ornaments and vessels. And gold and silver, they were used to make ornaments and vessels too. Then the most striking finds were the beads, weights and the blades. The seals were made out of stone, which were generally rectangular in shape, and they usually had an animal carved on them. The Harappans, they made the pots with beautiful black designs, and you can see one such pot on page number 6. And cotton was also grown at Mehrgarh from about 7000 years ago. How did they come to know? They came to know by seeing the actual pieces of cloth that were found attached to the lid of a silver vase and some copper objects at Mohenjo-daro. And the archaeologists, they also found the spindle whorls made of terracotta and faience, and these were used to spin thread. What is faience, children? We learned that it is a material that is artificially produced, and a gum was used to shape sand or powdered quartz into an object, and the objects were then glazed, resulting in a shiny glassy surface, and the colors of the glaze were usually blue or sea green. And faience was used to make beads, bangles, earrings and tiny vessels, and many of the things that were produced were probably the work of specialists. And a specialist is a person who is trained to do only one kind of work. And perhaps some women and men, they may have been specialists. Then we learned about in search of raw materials. That is, the raw materials are substances that are either found naturally or produced by farmers or herders. While some of the raw materials that the Harappans used were available locally, but many items were brought in from distant places, such as copper from present-day Rajasthan and Oman in West Asia, and tin, which was mixed with copper to produce bronze, may have been brought from present-day Afghanistan and Iran, and gold from present-day Karnataka, and precious stones from present-day Gujarat, Iran and Afghanistan. And the wheel was used in carts for carrying the goods from one place to another. And we also learnt about food for people in the cities. That is, the people who were living in the countryside, they grew crops and reared animals. That is, the farmers and herders, they supplied food to the craftspersons, scribes and rulers that were living in the cities. And the Harappans, they grew wheat, barley, pulses, peas, rice, sesame, linseed and mustard. And they used a new tool, that is the plough, to dig the earth for turning the soil and planting seeds. Children, here you can see the terracotta toys
that are shown, that is a toy cart and a toy plow. So the children, they would have preferred toy carts for playing instead of plows. And as this region does not receive heavy rainfall, so some form of irrigation may have been used, that is the water was stored and supplied to the fields when the plants were growing. And the Harappans, they reared cattle, sheep, goat and buffalo. And the water and pastures, they were available around the settlements. However, in the dry summer months, the large herds of animals, they were taken to greater distances in search of grass and water. And they also collected fruits like bear and caught fish and hunted wild animals like the antelope. Children, I hope that you have understood the topics that we have learned today clearly. We shall learn more about this lesson in our next class. Till then, goodbye, children.